Thursday, August 17th, 2023.
Kiss Country 99.9. Blasting through your speakers like the Kool-Aid Man.
Oh, yeah!
Florida hair just don't care. We're Kiss Country 99.9. Country 99.9. Dina B says she's kind of frustrated. She says everything she likes is either expensive, illegal, or won't text her back. TC and Dina B on Kiss Country 99.9.
Yeah, this is it.
This is it, the beginning of school for our friends in Miami-Dade County. Good morning, we are TC and Dina B. We also yesterday put up that pre-sale for Stars and Strings. There are still a few tickets left for the pre-sale before they go on sale to the general public tomorrow morning. If you did not get that pre-sale code, hit us up on social at KissCountry99.9. We can hit you up with it, and you can get tickets for everybody else.
Yeah, last year we sold out very quickly, so if you don't want to have to wait till tomorrow, today is the day to really get on that ahead of time.
Yeah, they are moving pretty swimmingly as well. So on the show today, it is Throwback Thursday, which is great news because that means it's already Thursday. We have more tickets to send you to see Billy Currington, too, by the way, at 8:50 this morning.
And we got
to
look at traffic for your early morning commute, heading back to school with the kiddos. Miami-Dade County, that's coming up after Kane and Caitlin Brown. Here's Thank God.
I was lost, you found a way to bring me back. Needed forgiveness, you always gave me that.
Kiss Country Traffic.
Your commute looking good this morning. This traffic report is brought to you by Griff's Western Inc. No incidents to report early this morning. You're moving at posted speeds. That's traffic. I'm Elia Escobar on Kiss Country 99.9.
Life comes with a lot of decisions.
Or download the app today.
It was actually around this time a couple of years ago when I decided to upgrade to PGT impact-resistant windows and doors. Hurricane season goes until November. There's still time to call my good friends at Buckley Window today to get your free estimate. Hey, it's Dina B. And since I got my PGT windows and doors, house stays way cooler, my electric bill went down, and the stress off my shoulders not having to deal with wood or shutters every time they name a storm. Call Buckley Window at 954-945-9134 or buckleywindow.com.
Have you ever covered a carpet stain with a rug?
Due to binding offer or guarantee of coverage.
This hour of music brought to you by Venue Laser and Vision. Get $500 off your LASIK procedure at VenueLaser.com.
Hey, it's Luke Braun.
Hey, this is Carrie Underway.
I'm Morgan Wallen.
That sounds amazing.
Kiss Country 99.9.
Today's top stories in 2 minutes. Here's what's trending with TC and Dina B on Kiss Country. Brought to you by Paul Bange Roofing. Give Paul a call at 954-981-ROOF.
Aldi said Wednesday it plans to buy 400 Winn-Dixie and Harvey supermarkets in the southern part of the United States.
That would be us.
Yep. Under a proposed merger agreement, Aldi will acquire all outstanding shares of Jacksonville, Florida-based Southeastern Grocers, Inc., the parent company, obviously, of Winn-Dixie and Harvey's.
Okay.
If the deal is approved, it's expected to close in the first half of 2024. The Winn-Dixie and Harvey supermarkets it's acquiring are primarily in Alabama, Florida, Georgia, Louisiana, and Mississippi.
Well, I mean, I think this is good news for all because Winn-Dixie has kind of been on the downswing for a little while now. So for someone to come in, bail them out, Aldi. I mean, I hear a lot of people, I've never actually been to one, but I hear a lot of people, I mean, they love going there. So it gives you another option here. If you want to go, I mean, it's never going to get better than Publix, but it's a good another option if it's close to you.
Don't hold back on where you love to shop.
I mean, it's just true. There's nowhere on the planet better than shopping anywhere in Publix. It's nothing against Aldi. It's just Publix is so good.
Well, Aldi is, it just reminds me a lot of an Albertsons from back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
So they do have a lot of discounts. And what I do really enjoy are the holidays. They have those advent calendars.
Oh, the ones with the little chocolates inside?
All sorts of things.
Get the ones
they
with
the... They do cheese. They do some, like, wine ones. Yeah,
there we go. There we go. As you keep going, I know the ones you're
doing. Yeah.
Uh-huh. They're good time, those advent calendars, though.
We had to do ones with, like, little liquor bottles.
Yeah. I knew we were going to get there.
Just do a shot.
All right, we'll start doing it.
December 1st. Woo!
Get ready, everyone. Our December shows are going to be magical.
I think that'd be fun. Pumpkin spice. Speaking of fun, pumpkin spice season is officially back at Dunkin'. Even though fall doesn't officially start until September 23rd, Dunkin' dropped its full fall menu yesterday.
There we go.
The fall favorites include the pumpkin spice signature latte, nutty pumpkin coffee, or you can simply add a pumpkin swirl, which I loved hearing this. You can add a pumpkin squirrel.
A pumpkin swirl.
That'd be a different drink.
You don't say.
A pumpkin swirl to any hot or iced coffee,
espresso drink,
cold brew, or frozen coffee to basically like customize your own beverage.
I love that because if you don't want full pumpkin but you want a little taste of it, you get the pumpkin swirl, you see a pumpkin squirrel, and everyone's having a good time. You already sorted those advent calendars?
No, I didn't.
No, not yet. Okay.
No, I did not. But as for the food, Dunkin' brought back their pumpkin cake donut and munchkins, pumpkin muffins, and the maple sugar bacon is back as well. So get to
it. Good time.
Feeling fallish right now just talking about
it. Yeah, it's going to be 9,000 degrees outside, but you get your pumpkin squirrel going today, baby.
It's Jordan Davis. Good morning.
Swear that you're staying single next thing you know.
You're just getting in your car, getting ready to start the day. Thanks for starting it with us. Good morning. We are TC and Dina B. Want to remind you, if you did not get that pre-sale code for our Kiss Country and Odyssey Stars and Strings, you can hit us up on social media at KissCountry99.9. There's still a few of those pre-sale tickets left. If you want them, we'll give you the code. You can go buy them and start your Thursday on a great note.
And this wouldn't be a great note if you got the dengue fever.
No, it wouldn't.
A rise in dengue fever cases has prompted Florida officials to issue a health alert for the mosquito-borne illness. At last check, more cases are popping up in Broward and Miami-Dade counties. So far, there have been a total of 10 cases directly from mosquito bites here in Florida. Health officials said individuals should use insect repellent, wear long-sleeved shirts, of course, long pants, and control mosquitoes inside and outside of your home in order to prevent mosquito bites. Hope to not spread dengue fever or even malaria, because they even said that there were 7 cases of malaria this year.
That's actually really frightening.
So, yeah. I mean, the rain doesn't help. The
nothing
mugginess
you can do.
And the heat doesn't help either.
Once you open your door or your garage, I mean, they're coming in. So you just got to do your best to fight them off. You got to be really quick. Have a quick eye so you can smash those little buggers when
you
see them.
Just like that.
Just like it.
Do it again in case.
Oh,
there you go.
We got one.
Practice, folks.
It's tough, especially when you have one in your house and you can never get it, and it's like the ultimate rivalry. It's in there for a night. It keeps biting you, so get ready, everyone.
I'm Mr. Miyagi when it comes to that.
Yeah.
I'm determined.
You have to be.
Traffic next.
Becky was a beauty from South Alabama. Her daddy had a heart like a 9-pound hammer. What was I thinking?
Kiss Country 99.9.
In my t-shirt, in my ride, running circles in my mind. Yeah, you're the only girl in mind.
We're all in the same boat.
Life comes with a lot of decisions, and it
Hilton for the stay.
Don't miss a minute of TC and Dina B. This is Kiss Country from the Anna Jar and Levine Accident Attorney Studio.
Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Your favorites are right here.
I need something you prove. You ain't a rock and a hard place.
Kiss Country 99.9.
Dare to compare.
Wake up with the Eddie Fox Show.
This train is off the tracks
on 99.9 Kiss Country.
Well, it's Friday Eve.
Almost the weekend time.
My name's Eddie Fox. Her name's Amanda Fox. This is 99.9 Kiss Country. So, Mamaw, who has the baby right now?
Oh, ma'am. Okay, my mother.
Share the story about the Eggo liquor.
Well, I mean, after you have the baby, I completely understand.
It's not for the baby, is it?
Well, the baby. For her teeth. Just her teeth, you know.
Well, if you if you shy away from buying Eggo waffles because they don't seem adult enough, they're now elevating the experience in a way that you can't get without being carded.
Okay, so it's a It's like a
liqueur.
Okay,
it's a special booze that pairs well with waffles. Apparently, Eggo teamed up with Sugarlands Distilling.
Oh, okay.
No relation to the group.
But that's in over in Tennessee, right?
It is.
Yeah.
It's called Eggo Brunch in a Jar Sipping Cream. 20% alcohol, 40 proof.
So it tastes like an Eggo, like maple syrup?
I guess, ish. Special morning booze is the way I like to look at it.
You know, I do like me a good morning booze. I'm just kidding. I never have a morning booze anymore.
Booze or morning buzz? Either way.
Either way.
This is not the first time Eggo's gotten drunk, by the way.
Okay.
Holidays last year, they partnered with the same distillery to make Eggo Nog, which was Eggo waffle-flavored eggnog.
How much does that alcohol, does that say that is?
That is 20%.
Woo!
40 proof. 20% alcohol, 40 proof.
Okay.
Seamlessly blends the flavors of toasted Eggo waffles, sweet maple syrup, and rich butter with a hint of smoky bacon. Mmm! Is it on sale right now?
It says.
Oh, man. That sounds pretty good, actually.
Appalachian Sipping Cream.
Appalachian Sipping Cream. Not Appalachian. No, no, no. Never Appalachian. Just in time for Christmas.
This right, yeah.
Absolutely fantastic.
Good morning, I'm Mark Sterling. North Carolina lawmakers are overriding the governor on multiple bills addressing gender. Enough Republicans voted in favor of.
At Consumer Cellular.
Additional terms and conditions apply.
So it is back to school.
Back to reality.
Back to school. So I'm just curious, moms and dads, when you drop your youngin' off for the first time, or maybe you're dropping them off at college, what do you do as you leave? Do you sit there and cry? Do you go to the theme park? Do you go to the bar? What? How are you dealing with that big change in your life? Love to hear from you. About 3 minutes here.
Hello. Are you ready?
Do it. The Eddie Fox Show in the morning.
I just love y'all. You're better than biscuits and gravy and ain't nearly as messy.
WKSFFM, Old Fort Asheville.
Take five.
Oh, back to school.
It will test your head and your mind and your brain, too.
Big old country. Morning, it's Eddie Fox and Amanda Fox on 99.9 Kiss Country. So, how are you dealing with back to school, Mom and Daddy? Maybe it's your first one into kindergarten.
Oh, I'm going to be a mess when that day comes.
I'm already a mess. God, just thinking about it. Oh, man. Or maybe you're dropping your youngins off at college. That's a big step. So, how you dealing with this? What, I mean, I can't even imagine the range of emotions. It could be, get on!
Yeah, you could be excited because maybe you're going to be empty nesters now and you have some freedom. You could be very sad because they've never been away from home.
Just wondering if you have any advice for folks going through this for the first time. Maybe you've been there with your kids and you have some advice that could help these mamas and daddies struggling with this very thing. 240 KISS or toll free 1-800-303-KISS. We'd love to hear from you.
Wake up! Here comes that sun coming up.
99.9 KISS Country.
This morning I got up at 6:01.
Today's Hit Country.
Turn this out loud.
It's gonna get loud. 99.9
Kiss Country.
I only talk to God when I need a favor.
Amen. Best good to see y'all. It's Eddie Fox and Amanda Fox on 99.9 Kiss Country. Back to school.
I can't believe it's back to school time.
We're like 37 days, I think, away from fall if you're keeping track of that sort of
Man,
thing.
Man, I love my summer, but I do love my fall.
So back to school time can be tough for mamas and daddies. Maybe you're experiencing that first dropping a kid off or sending the kid off to college.
Aww.
Or how, if you've been through this before, you have any advice to offer up?
I have actually took my son to college last weekend.
Aww.
And yeah, and my daughter actually graduated 5 years ago from college, and she's a nurse now.
Oh, well, congratulations.
But thank you. She works at Mission, a neonatal intensive care nurse.
Oh, and we might have seen her.
Yeah.
You may have. So my advice is that it's sad as for us as parents, but you got to think of it this way. You did your job. You taught them to be independent, and you taught them to be, you know, outgoing and to be a productive human being in the world.
Very true.
So, yeah, it's got to be a proud moment.
It is. It's sad, but it's proud. My husband also lost his job at the mill, so he too's leaving me to travel, so I'm going to really be an empty nester, which I'm not used to. But I'm proud of all of them.
It's
well, if you get lonely, just call us and we'll talk to you.
Oh, Lord, you don't want to talk to me. I talk up a storm.
And so do we.
And get paid for it. I know. It's weird.
Hey, I need to do that. That'd be good. But you guys are awesome and make me smile in the morning.
We love you, honey. Thank
you
so
honey.
Much.
And congratulations on your kiddo. Sounds like you did a great job.
Well, thank you. Love you guys.
Back with more in a moment.
Do not be alarmed if you hear anything unusual.
The Eddie Fox Show in the morning on 99.9 Kiss Country.
Pure as these kids.
Get a free quote by visiting bugoutservice.com today.
Turning up the country.
Country.
Woo! Turn up the country.
99.9. Kiss Country.
She said, I've seen you in here before. I said, I've been here a time or two. May not be good as I once was, but I'm as good once as I ever was.
Doing. It's Eddie Fox and Amanda Fox on 99.9 Kiss Country. It's back to school.
Back to school time.
Back to
I've
school.
Already started seeing a bunch of the back to school pictures. They're
Y'all
so cute.
Are so very cute. So we're just curious if you're dropping off your youngin' for the first time, maybe kindergarten, maybe college, you're dropping the kids off at Western. Mamas and daddies who have been there before, you have any advice for these other mamas and daddies?
Good morning.
Hey,
I got
honey.
Some advice for those. For these folks who've got these children going back to school.
Yes, ma'am.
Y'all just got to pray over them children every day.
Yes.
As you get in the car, as you drop them off, that God would just put a hedge of protection around them, that he would protect their little brains, and that he would protect their little bodies.
Amen.
And that goes for the college kids, too.
Yeah. The Lord knows we need all the help there. And protection we can get.
Amen.
Honey,
all
we
right,
love
y'all
you.
Y'all have the best ever. We love
you
y'all.
You, too.
Take my hand, let me make you mine. I'm through waiting, taking my time. Oh, because I don't want to wait no more. Take my name and make it yours.
What are you doing? It's Eddie Fox and Amanda Fox on 99.9 Kiss Country from just down the hall to 570. WWNC.
What?
The Angry News Gnome.
That's a
throwing your
mark.
Papers around.
Darling, ladies and gentlemen.
Hard work. You weren't even here at 6:30. Where what? Were you?
We were here.
You were here?
Oh, I didn't see. You must not have had a light turned
on. We were
up.
Going through all the new swag that we got in the boxes back up there.
Is that a new hat?
This is not a new hat, no.
This
is
old
my
hat?
Old hat. It's good and broken
this
in.
This is the new hat.
We got new Kiss Country hats and t-shirts. Yeah.
Oh, I like those t-shirts. Like
y'all seen
color.
Them new Kiss Country thongs we got in? Oh, they're great.
We got gray hats, too, like light gray hats.
If we ever get Kiss Country thongs, it's going to be a problem.
I only order one.
It'd have been fine if it hadn't had Eddie Harwood model them, you know?
That ruins it for everyone.
And the phone will ring in 3,
and there
two,
you go, your breakfast.
North Carolina lawmakers, keyword for yesterday, override. They backed over Governor Roy Cooper like he was a speed bump multiple times yesterday. I believe there were 6 overrides
Oh, wow.
overall. One of those bills that they overrode that he tried to veto was one that banned transgender females from taking part in women's athletics. So the governor criticized lawmakers for passing bills that discriminate rather than passing a budget.
I wouldn't.
Yep, not even bothered. Guess who the top, who is near the top for filing lawsuits? They did this big survey, right, here in Buncombe. Well, it was all over the state, and it was hospitals.
Oh.
HCA got nailed. Now, this is kind of interesting, because the years that they did it, 2017 to 2022, remember, Mission hadn't been sold yet. So there's a little bit of conflicting data here, and Mission says that none of this happened while HCA owned it. And this is, it all dates back to between 20, I guess, what was it? Was it 2019 that the hospital sold?
I cannot remember.
I think that's
somewhere
when,
in there.
I think
seems
that's
like
when it sold. So, all, yeah, it's very kind of conflicting as to why the data is only, there's only some of it there. So I don't know. Hmm. We'll see what happens. But they say that those practices are no longer in effect because the state treasurer's office kind of put a kibosh on that stuff.
Interesting.
So, yeah. Kind of strange there. Guess what, Woodfin residents? You could take your single plastic bags and get rid of them.
This is
so
the,
let me tell you, I watched that meeting
ever.
The other night.
Dumbest
and
thing ever.
It was absolutely ridiculous. Oh, but also, stupidity. It can't even go into effect unless Buncombe County does it.
Right.
It's just a resolution unless Buncombe County does
and
it.
And I'll guarantee and then, you.
So, wait. Instead of focusing on maybe homeless people or
supporting the police.
No,
it was absolutely crazy how mad one person on that board got about plastic bags.
Oh, I know.
You mean childish.
Childish, yes.
I mean, I'll be honest. My dad is on that board and how mean they were to my father. It was like appalling about how people were treating him and how they were treating other people that were there.
I don't get it. It's a plastic. I mean,
and that's me putting that out there.
So what's the
this
what's
is
the
all about inclusivity?
Yeah, it's all about stupidity.
You must be inclusive. Yeah, well, it's they rhyme basically.
Well, did
you know
see
what?
The picture I posted last night? Ellie's you like, can you quote ain't taking me on my that. Plastic bags. She's like wrapped up in them.
Did you see that?
I did. Oh my God. I did notice that, and I knew exactly what I was looking at when I saw
it. The plastic bag thing is stupid, and you can quote me on that.
Yeah. I just ridiculous don't think there's enough evidence at
stupidity.
This point
there's
to,
not.
To prove what they're trying
and again,
to say.
Sorry. I ask, what do they expect people to do when they have to clean up the dog poop? If you're washing those bags out and reusing them, go get me the ball peen hammer because you need a strike.
Hey, you see, brought the ball peen hammer back in.
Back with more in a moment.
Do not be alarmed if you hear anything unusual.
The Eddie Fox Show in the morning on 99.9 Kiss Country.
This report is sponsored by Mattress Firm. There's no better time to upgrade your Z's than during Mattress Firm's best sale of the year.
Get in the zone, AutoZone.
Today's hit country.
All the country vibes.
Country music coming at ya.
99.9 Kiss Country.
I love a first cast when the water's glass and the line starts to run. Well, that first sip of a cold beer when the working week's done.